You unlock God's word, you unlock God's power. You believe God's word, you believe in His miracles. Nandun na yung miracle. Because one thing God cannot do, God cannot lie. He said it, it will come to pass. And let it be done according to what we believe. Last but not least, number six. We're done for today. Because God has a promise for all our needs. Do you believe that?
Amen.
Whatever need we may have, God has a promise. God has a word for you. All in. One stop shop. Everything you need is there. Do we have enough reasons to believe the word of God today?
Yes.
Will you depend, put your faith in the promises of God and not according to your situation? Not according to what's happening to you? Not even according to the bleak future ahead of you? What will happen to the world? What will happen to the economy? What will happen to this? What will happen to that? Why would we even consider our future is secured according to the promises of God? Amen? Amen? Let's bow our heads. Father God, I pray that you reinforce your word into our hearts. And as Christians, may we believe every word that your Bible has written. May we put our security, may we depend on your word and give us the everlasting assurance according to your word. This morning, if we have in our midst people, hopers, who are in the middle of crises, in the middle of confusion, in the middle of fear or worry or doubts, remember what Jesus said, heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of God will not pass away. I pray this morning that we may surrender our doubts, our fears at the foot of the cross. What is it? What is it that's bothering you? What is it that's troubling you? What is it that steals away your peace? What are you asking God to remove from your life? Are you afraid that you will not reach your dreams, your desires? You see, people of God, no one can be assured of tomorrow. Who is very sure here that you will still get to see the light of day tomorrow? Not even one. That's why at this time I pray, whatever is loading us up, whatever is waiting us up, whatever is burdening us up, whatever load we're carrying on our shoulders, I pray that you unload it right here, right now. Let us all stand, everybody standing. And I can just sense that there are people in this room, people here today, who have come today with a heavy heart, have come today with some burdens, some loads. I'd like to assure you of a promise in the Word of God that says, Jesus said, "Come unto me, all you who are heavily laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon me, for my burden is light, and I will give you rest." I pray this morning that you will unload to God what is in your heart. Unload to God what is weighing you down. Unload to God what is troubling you. Unload to God what has been keeping your heart heavy. And you can do it right now. Do it right now. Call to Him. Say, "Lord, I am laying this burden at the foot of the cross." Just tell God, "Lord, I am submitting. I don't know why." You see, you don't need to understand why. Because God's promises is beyond logic and beyond your understanding. Don't help God. Don't explain to God. God knows more. Just leave it to Him. Leave it in the cross. Unload it at the foot of the cross. Future, anxiety, fear. If you're experiencing that, there is a part in your life you have not surrendered to God yet. Today is the day of surrender. Today is the day you unload to God and do it. Right now. Just pray. Just begin to talk to God. Just begin to unload to God what has been troubling you. Yes, God is listening. God is waiting. I can see some shoulders being freed from the burden. I can see some hearts being unclouded by all the doubts and the fears and the insecurities. The fears and the doubts, the worries. God is clearing you up, brother. God is clearing you up, sister, right here, right now. You don't need to worry. Just need to believe. Just need to put our faith in God's word. Just put the anchor of your soul into the word of God. Something is happening here today. I can sense it. I can see it. People are just getting free. People are just setting themselves free from the tangles, entanglement of this world. And Lord, I pray for peace to come down right now. Receive. Just lift up your hand and receive God's peace. Telling you, "I got this." God is telling you, "I got this, brother. I got this. I receive it. Now I'm giving you peace." Hallelujah. Receive it. Thank the Lord for it. Open your mouth and begin to give thanks to God. Open your mouth and begin to give thanks to God. Open your mouth and begin to praise Him. Something's happening. Something's happening in our midst right now. Some people are being unburdened. Some people are being free from heavy loads. You don't need to carry it. Jesus already carried it for you. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Set your people free from the burdens, from the fears, from the doubts, from the things that scares us. Because we know, Lord, our lives are in your hand. We don't need to know what. We don't need to know how. We just need to know who holds our future, who holds our life, and it is none other than Jesus. Thank you, Father. Someone is being set free here today, right here. You are free. and enjoy your freedom, for it is what Jesus had paid for you. And for me. We thank you. We praise you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Get a hug. Can someone just feel that blessing? Feel that release. Feel that miracle of God in you. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell you're free. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, exciting days are coming. It's an exciting days are coming. Let's call on who's giving our sister rest.
Thank you,
Lord.
This is exciting times. And even it's exciting at this moment because we're going to give and continue to honor God. Yes, Father, we thank you, Lord God, that your word is true. And we can depend on your word, oh God. And Father, we thank you, O God, that you have been faithful in our lives, O God. And as we continue to honor you and worship you, Lord, tithes and offerings, Father, we don't need to ask for more blessings. Because it's your nature, O God, to continually bless your people, Lord God. Father, we thank you, Lord, for giving us the ability to work, to help, to gain blessings, O God, and even to bless more people, O God. Father, we thank you, O God, that Lord, even as we worship you, you will be glorified, O God. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that through these blessings, O God, Lord, a lot of people will be blessed through us, O God. And Father, we thank you, Lord, for giving us, Lord, this opportunity, O God, to bless you, O Lord, even, Lord God, to bless other people. Father, once more, may you be glorified, Lord God, in our gifts and offering. And Father, we thank you in Jesus' name.
It's time to greet our birthday celebrants. Lalo na ng November na mga birthday ng November ay magaganda sa mga babae. Amen na yung isa pa sa mga. November 1, Sister Marilyn Cruz. November 2, Ryan Mateo. November 5, alegría, mi placer.
Partake Thank you, God, for the hands that have prepared the food. Thank you, God, for those that have brought sacrifice. We continue to pray that you bless them, Lord. Another special prayer for Tita Maggie, Lord. Continue to heal her, strengthen her. Continue to watch over her body, strengthen her immune system, and whatever is aiding her and causing her discomfort. Lord, we pray, Father God, that you just take it away from her. Take that burden away from her, Lord, Father God. This we pray in Jesus' name.
Okay, lang ni KJ na. Para yung mga pilito na brat, ano yung mga
Gracias.